my God, what a juicy development. You know, Kevin Feige, this is beautiful. You know, there is a lot of drama in the blockbuster space in Hollywood right now, and this is such an incredible story for a number of reasons. Six, to be exact. Let's count them down. All right, number one, reason number one. With Warner Brothers skipping Comic-Con this year, some of us hoped, that the studio might make some major DC headlines peppered around the convention. You know, we'll make our own damn news whenever we damn well please. That's how it was sold to us that they were skipping Comic-Con. Remember, to kind of make everyone feel better, they were like, here's a Wonder Woman poster right now. Well, where are the headlines this week or even recently? Like legit headlines from the studio where there's been plenty of DC rumors as we've been discussing in leaks. But lo and behold, it's Marvel making a huge game-changing surprise headline prior to its already scheduled Saturday night panel, where we had a pretty good idea of the plethora of movies that Kevin Feige is going to officially announce, and Thor 4 wasn't one of them. But Thor 4 is happening because Kevin Feige saw a window. Oh my God. All right, so reason number two. Apparently, Taika Waititi was available, or there was a window suddenly, because of all studios, Warner Brothers blinked with their live-action Akira script and delayed the filming start date. And Feige was like, ooh, hey, Taika Waititi, I see you have a couple of months there to fill. So, with Taika Waititi agreeing to do Thor 4, that put Akira too close to comfort as far as Warner Brothers was concerned, so they blinked again. And instead of saying, hey, it's a little something called a contract and a commitment, Taika Waititi, they were like, let's just put Akira on indefinite hold. And maybe, hopefully, Taika Waititi will come back to us after Marvel's done with him. Oh my God! So yes, Taika Waititi is going to not only direct Thor 4, but write it as well. The deal has been inked, which leads to reason number three, Taika Waititi is writing Thor 4. Expect Korg to get a lot more screen time, which I have mixed feelings about. I think a little bit of Korg goes a long way, in a good way. But wow, remember, Waititi did not write Thor Ragnarok, even though his fingerprints, of course, are all over it. So if you thought Thor Ragnarok was wonderfully weird, you ain't seen nothing yet. Unless, of course, you've been lucky enough to see any of Waititi's earlier films, which are all pretty freaking weird. Again, wonderfully so. Not particularly commercial. They might want to stick another writer on there with Taika Waititi just to kind of maybe balance them out, right? I thought that, you know, Christopher Yost, you know, that screenwriting duo did a nice job with Thor Ragnarok, so maybe they might want to work with Taika Waititi here. Although Taika Waititi is a pretty strong creative force, and I suspect he really wouldn't want to work with anyone. But you know what? You know what I'd point out if I were Kevin Feige? And I'm going to point out right now, Taika Waititi as a writer is involved in that Akira script that has so many problems, right? He's not a silver bullet when it comes to screenwriting, right? But I would think this, just also to be fair though, that a lot of the Akira problems and why that's such a tough script to crack are probably from two situations. A, material that's really hard to make accessible to mainstream audiences. I've seen Akira. I can't really tell you what happens in the third act. And then also B, and I really love this kind of stuff, so if anyone's gonna get it, it's me. And I'm curious how you feel about Akira, if it could ever be made truly mainstream. And then B, trying to keep a live-action Akira authentic, which they should, but also still trying to make sure it has the best shot of having a global audience, which they also should. That's a very difficult balancing act. I still feel that maybe Jordan Peele would have been the better talent for that property. But anyway, all right, so next, reason number four that this is so dramatic. All right, this flies in the face of the unspoken, it was unspoken to be fair, but the unspoken MCU rule of three and done, right? Three Iron Man movies, three Captain America movies, everyone gets their trilogy, then they're done. That was the assumption everyone was working under, right? Now, to be fair though, when it comes to Thor, two of his movies don't really count, right? I mean, the character was completely and successfully reimagined for his third film, with many of us already feeling and hoping that that would really be the first Thor movie even before this announcement. We were like, the character just got good. You can't get rid of him now. Although I saw that some of you felt his shtick had already gotten old with Avengers Endgame. I didn't feel that way. I think there's still a lot left in the tank, although I hope that Taika Waititi realizes that's a good thing. Taika Waititi is, I think, a strong comedic writer, like actually a writer instead of relying heavily on improvisation. And I think Chris Hemsworth is a fabulous comedian, but I think he has absolutely no improbability. So, I mean, maybe a little, but certainly not enough to support a movie. So I would love for him to have a strong comedic script to knock out of the park, right? With Mjolnir. All right, still, when it comes to talent, right, and their representation, I think it's probably very interesting to them that suddenly they don't have to leave the MCU after three movies, right? I mean, Paul Rudd's just been worried about getting his first trilogy completed, but Chris Hemsworth is potentially embarking on a new one, right? How do Robert Downey Jr. and Chris Evans feel about this? Did they know about the situation when they agreed to their Endgame storylines? I mean, this works out for Feige wonderfully. The house always wins, as of course they say, because it's true. But this is a brilliant carrot to entice both Downey Jr. and Evans to come back maybe a little faster than they would have otherwise. Right now they're like, oh, it was a fun ride. It was such an honor. Now they're probably like, what the hell? I mean, there are ways, as we've discussed, artificial intelligence for Tony, Captain America's life with Peggy. There's a link to my video discussing that in detail down below in the video description. Which leads me, though, to number five, reason number five this is such a dramatic, juicy headline, and that this probably, I would assume, it should, lights a fire under all the existing Marvel talent, in front of and behind the camera, to stay on their toes, keep their characters fresh, because if they do, they may also not have to go home. This removes the ticking clock from the MCU. There's only three movies a year. These spots are becoming incredibly valuable, right? Now, remember, being part of the MCU props up talent's entire careers. Fans are interested in anything they do in and out of Marvel. Will the interest hold once they leave? Robert Downey Jr. and Chris Evans are about to find that out. It hasn't looked so good it's been tough even when actors are in the MCU. When they leave, wow. I mean, Hemsworth doesn't have to find out. And you know what? I think that he already got a little bit of a taste of it, and it wasn't good. I mean, of all the actors, he really needed to stay, and stay he is. Now, finally, juicy reason number six. After Endgame, the MCU seemed to set up that Thor would be co-starring in Guardians of the Galaxy 3. But as many of you were quick to point out, especially those of you who are strong supporters of James Gunn, he already turned in his script, a script that Kevin Feige liked so much, he actually put his career on the line and fought for James Gunn to come back. This script better be amazing, especially considering many of you, I liked Guardians of the Galaxy 2 over 1, but many of you felt it was, it was not of the same caliber. There's a lot riding on Guardians of the Galaxy 3, but as far as Gunn's vision was concerned, Thor wasn't in it. So the result? Thor gets another solo movie. Wow, what would you like to see happen in Thor 4? Does the character deserve to be the one that sticks around beyond his initial three movies, right? Is he gonna be a delightful rainbow bridge to the new lineup of Avengers, right? You keep one just to, you know, he is very powerful, and I think many of us, as we've discussed, I love one of your jokes about this, we wanna see Thor versus Captain Marvel. Who is the most powerful Avenger? As one of you said, when she takes out a ship, Thor's argument is that still just counts as one. I love it. I actually think they would be, I would like to see them together in a movie. Although, as I just said, this real estate's becoming incredibly valuable, and there's no, you know, who knows when we'll get another Avengers movie, who knows when we'll get Captain Marvel 2, and that all relies on Kevin Feige, the sole producer over there at the MCU. There's no one else's ear anyone can bend. All right, so anyway, share your thoughts about this down below. I'll be sharing my own ideas soon. I have to see, because, you know, we might be getting details in just a matter of days of what this movie will be about, right? Because we might at least get a title, you know, just like when we got Thor Ragnarok. But Taika Waititi just signed this deal, so he might be pondering it for a little while. So anyway, hit subscribe. And of course, as always, you can check out some more videos right now.